Good morning, everyone. It's my pleasure to participate in this Digitech Conclave here today, organized by etgovernment.com on the theme of building a future-ready digital ecosystem. Now, digital services today have, I'm sure you agree, come a really long way from what they used to be at least a few years ago. And it is thanks to the important work that has happened on not just improving core technologies, but also in terms of the convergence of various technology trends, whether it was the internet or the cloud or even mobile. And this has only been possible because each trend has actually built on top of what was already existing to really create unique offerings. And without any one of these trends, you know, many of the services that we take for granted today would really not be the same, right? Whether it is calling an Uber, or if you're going to be using the Arogya Setu app, then you know, you wouldn't really treat it as disruptive technology if it wasn't for all these technologies really coming together to complement each other. So just imagine if you had to scramble to find yourself a Wi-Fi hotspot when you're hailing a taxi, or if you had to whip up your laptop in the rain, you know, just to access an application. It just would not be the same, right? So the convergence of smartphones, 4G networks, which is now, you know, moving towards 5G, and cloud computing has definitely enabled a smart new world, a smarter new world, I would say. And today, we are creating the next set of technologies that will become the things that are so embedded in our lives and so indispensable in our daily habits that we will wonder, what did we ever do without them? And the possibilities that we will see and that we are seeing already with edge technologies are equally as exciting, because we are seeing the coming together of a physical world with the digital world, and there are endless possibilities. So at Red Hat, we truly believe that open unlocks the world's potential, because at Red Hat, we have always been a champion of the fact that open, collaborative, and inclusive community innovation cannot happen behind closed doors. Open source has empowered collaboration, and working together has helped people come across organizations and industries to build upon robust shared platforms much, much more quickly than how individual companies or individuals themselves could have done all by themselves. And we expect that these new technologies are going to have profound implications on our society, in our daily lives, how we interact with each other, and even the social fabric of the entire world. Open source definitely fuels rapid innovation. And the culture of open source is really the heart of its entire power, because it requires collaboration and it requires transparency for us to work. But the benefits are really huge, because shared problems are solved much faster. So open source has been and continues to be the innovation engine for the entire industry, and the entire ecosystem brings people together to focus on a common problem that can be solved with software. And what we are really excited about is that if we can continue to collaborate in nascent technologies like, you know, 5G, edge, we could really create some exciting common foundations much sooner than, you know, if we had tried to do it on our own. Open source communities, and the reason why we love working in the open source communities is that they're very, very good at rapid innovation, collaboration, addressing common problems with the power of a community, and much, much more. However, today, enterprises, you know, businesses, their needs are some that the communities do not and probably should not have to address. And that is where Red Hat actually steps in. So we help organizations to interact with the open source technologies they need, getting the changes, getting the requests upstream. Upstream is where the community projects happen. And we are trusted by the communities that cultivate the innovation, because they know that we are not going to stifle the innovation, we are not going to hold it, because we definitely believe, as I've been saying for the last few minutes, is by sharing, we can actually make it better. So what we do is we refine the community software, and by making sure that we are performing the right quality control the right integration tasks and standardizing some of the user interface. And we offer that innovation of the community software with the stability of enterprise life cycle support and technical support, right? So the community trusts us, our customers trust us, and this has become our solid business model. So we believe that open standards and open source create the best open hybrid cloud architecture, because all said and done, today's world is a hybrid world, because no company put all its apps out there on the public cloud, and neither will they keep everything on-prem or in their own data centers, right? Most companies have evolved to a hybrid model where they have heterogeneous environments. And in such a heterogeneous environment, our recommended strategy is that you have to look at an open hybrid cloud as your strategy for architecting, for developing, and operating a mix of applications so that you can truly take the benefit of the cloud experience and at the same time bring in the speed, stability, and scale required for digital business transformation. Why do we call it open? Because it's based on open software, open source software for access to stable community innovation, open standards so that you have a much, much broader compatibility, and open APIs so that you have very flexible integrations. Now, the question that we have to ask our customers really is that when you want to develop applications, and today a lot of applications are the way that many of our customers are driving innovation, whether it is in the government in terms of the citizen services, or whether you're a bank or a factory shop floor. So if you are developing innovative applications, the question that begs asking is, are you running it on the right foundation? That becomes extremely important, right? And how can you then make sure that your open hybrid cloud strategy is a way by which you can build in stability and future-proof your infrastructure by building on a proven foundation? From clouds to containers to Kubernetes and automation, you know, Linux has become a very powerful and proven platform for innovation. If someone wants to move to the cloud, then Linux delivers consistency. You want to containerize, and today containerizing applications is the way companies are working to bring in agility to their applications, then Linux includes container and development tooling to power those containers. Do you want to be more secure? Then Linux is designed with a security focus to safeguard your systems and monitor for any potential threats. And today, with the world we live in, you know, cyber security threats are on the rise. And if you want to automate, then Linux provides consistent foundation and is the ideal environment today for automation. So enterprise innovation starts with Linux. So building on Linux gives you the stability that you need, even as things are changing in the future. Just if you have a look at this slide here, you'll see that the power of this whole open architecture from Red Hat comes because of this thriving ecosystem that we have out here, with over 4,900 certified ISVs and over 5,500 tested, verified, and supported hardware types and components and clouds. You can see some of the big, large hyperscalers here as well. The entire RHEL ecosystem is ensuring that when you're building on this architecture, you're able to use the technologies that you need in order to run your business without worrying about the complexity of, you know, what is going to be the hardware, you know, what is going to be the application compatibility, etc. And then, you know, once you have that foundation, another very important open platform that you need to think about is, we talked about containers, right, to bring agility to your applications. Then when you want to manage those containers at scale, then the open hybrid cloud strategy that most companies are adopting today is Kubernetes. So when you couple the developer benefits, which an enterprise Kubernetes solution can actually enable, then really the Linux operating system that built the foundation on, along with that, you will find that you will be able to architect for any cloud. So you're bringing the stability and security of the Linux operating system, and you're bringing the speed and agility that comes from the Kubernetes application platform. So in this way, you're able to actually differentiate software to really power, you know, whatever it is that you're trying to do in terms of the services that you're trying to bring to your end customers. So as Red Hat, we have been pioneering the enterprise Kubernetes-based application development and delivery platform. And very recently, Forrester had clearly earmarked us as the leading platform for both developers and operators. So Red Hat OpenShift is built on RHEL, that is Red Hat Enterprise Linux, and it also provides a secure foundation for the entire application infrastructure that runs on thousands of certified hardware and cloud vendor technologies. This is important because only Red Hat provides that single platform that can run on any infrastructure and give you that consistency that you need for development and operations across all the clouds. Now, this Red Hat platform is also available as a managed service on all the four major cloud platforms to provide a variety of consumption models for customers, from vendor managed to customer installed and managed. So there's a lot of flexibility and choice. With an open hybrid cloud strategy, another outcome that you can realize is that you will be able to standardize and unify all your IT automation, because you will get an open automation platform across your IT. So Ansible automation platform today is a great choice for the standardization that organizations need to bring in to fit in, you know, automation into their overall strategy. Because through this platform, you can actually connect users across any IT domain. And I'm sure you'll all agree that, you know, when you want to drive any kind of transformation within companies, the culture part is extremely important, which means along with tools and processes, people need to be brought in. And that cultural change becomes that much more easier if you are able to help people on that journey by able to streamline the way they interact with each other via automation. So customers that choose automation and Ansible automation in particular have seen on an average almost close to 500% return on their investment with an average payback of just 5 months, right? So this becomes extremely critical even when you're looking at the application delivery with Red Hat OpenShift. You can look at how you can automate some of the operations with over-the-air updates and via OpenShift operators. And you can also look at how you can automate the complete build, test, and delivery via built-in CI/CD, that is continuous integration, continuous delivery tooling. And then, of course, the ultimate outcome would be for an open hybrid cloud strategy is if you're able to run and manage applications anywhere, which can help you achieve the kind of scale you need, because today we are looking at explosive and unprecedented growth with the number of users, right, that are the end users of the applications that we are taking to market. So with the foundation that you have of Red Hat Enterprise Linux and the application platform capabilities that you have with Red Hat OpenShift, we can now layer on application and data services and the complete management portfolio. And you can be sure that these are all guaranteed to work together, and because they are integrated right from the operating system level and they are patched and updated automatically. And that takes away a lot of the management, day-to-day management that one might have needed to do otherwise. So if we look at the ecosystem again, okay, this is our overall partner ecosystem. The common thread that you will see here is that all these partners are working with Red Hat to make sure that there is interoperability between their solutions and Red Hat solutions, including Red Hat Container Platform via certification, whether that is for containers, operators, or even some of the cloud native network functions. And finally, I would like to touch upon Red Hat and Digital India. We are very, very appreciative of the fact that the government of India has taken multiple steps towards easing the way we can do business from the point of view of policies, guidelines, and processes. Whether it is Digital India, that is ensuring that every program is digital ready and transforming India into a digital empowered society and knowledge economy, whether it is using paperless, cashless, and faceless processes, or the fact that the government of India has a published policy to adopt open standards and has a preference for open source software and open technologies for all their IT initiatives, I believe that these are truly game-changing. It is definitely going to bring a lot of transparency and simplicity in the overall system, along with accountability, and hopefully propel us forward to that vision of 5 trillion economy. So Red Hat and open source have contributed to several India digital initiatives in the last decade, and we continue to participate in many others, whether it is building a common infrastructure, a platform that is modern and that can span heterogeneous environments, or promoting an open API-based communication for better data exchange, or whether it is to create a microservices-based architecture so that you can, some of these digital initiatives can really benefit from the modularity that containers bring. We are proud to have played a significant role in many of these programs that have adopted open source, and we continue to partner in future programs as well, and we look forward to playing a strong role in Digital India. So to sum up, we believe the future is hybrid, and so are we. So any application, any footprint, no lock-in, that's the Red Hat promise. So thank you, and I wish you all a productive experience at this virtual Digitech Conclave from ET Government. Thank you very much.